Welcome to the small town of Sheerness, once a hive of activity, with a railway and picturesque views of the castle walls. The year is 1963. The worst winter on record in the UK has just been. In the small town of Sheerness, they felt like it was never going to end. Supplies grew low and the railway had been shut the year before. The only road in and out of the town was closed due to blockage. A group of people decided to hold a meeting in the grounds of the old castle to talk about whether or not to reopen the line that was once a thrive of activity.
Order please, we have asked you here to talk about us buying the line and running it as a preserve line. All in favour of us doing this, say aye.
Aye, man, all of us do.
Then it is settled. We will buy the line from the British Railway and run it as a preserve line. But we are going to get the starting capital for buying the line and starting to restore it, yes, so we can.
Soon, the to-be chairman, Mr. Robinson, arrived with a solution. Hello everyone. I've watched the decline of our town, and I agree it's time we did something to get it back to the way it was. I'd like to ask you a question, Mr. Clayton. If I were to place down a starting capital for such a venture, would this make me a shareholder?
Yes, this would make you a shareholder of the line.
Ah, I see. I'm willing to put forward such a starting capital for the project. And tell me, once my own costs have been recuperated, what will be done with the remaining profits?
We would continue to run the trains and pay back over time.
If I were to pay for this, I'm not the sort of man who you would find sat at home drinking his tea and eating biscuits, doing nothing with his life. No, sir. If I was to pay in, I would like to become the chairman of the line. And once my costs have been recuperated, I'd be happy not to work for the railway for no cost at all. Call it my little retirement project, if you will.
Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to draw this meeting to a close. All those in favour of Mr. Robinson becoming a chairman and the insol of the shareholders say aye.
No argument about that, sir.
Soon the townspeople set to work on the railway, in readiness for the first train of the season. However, while some old coaches were on their way, there was no engines to pull them. Even though Mr. Robinson's starting capital, there was not enough money to buy an engine. There was a meeting held about the engines. An old driver and a fireman were there. An argument sprung out about money not being left. In the back of the room, the driver thought about something and said what he thought. I know where I can find you an engine. You can find me an engine?
Even better. We can find you an engine and some trucks.
Mr. Robinson was surprised to learn from the old driver and fireman that an old 2MT that had worked for the factory had been left behind along with some old trucks. However, they could only see the trucks, not the engine. Just great. We have some trucks, but what good are they without an engine to pull them? It's the same story as with the carriages.
No, no, Mr. Robinson. Let's not give it up yet. How can we loose a steam engine?
Well, can you see them anywhere?
Nope.
You may not be able to see him, Mr. Robinson, but I can remember where I dropped his fire and left him. Where was it, man? The quicker we can get to him, the quicker we can light his fire and get him back to bed. Follow me, then. After a short time, they made it to the engine. Mr. Robinson's first thing was, my, my, who would have thought of it? An engine left here with his last train. Aye, amazing how he's lasted here so long. I'm going to oil round and start checking over his bearings.
I'm going to get some wood and rag to light this fire.
The fireman walked off to get some wood and rag, and the driver started to oil round. Mr. Robinson went in front to talk to the old engine. So then, what's your name?
My name is Jeff, sir.
So Jeff, tell me a little more about you, please.
I was recently overhauled, but my boiler has about 9 years left in it, I'd say. And as far as I'm aware, all my bearings are still okay. And I've sat here for a while, so I look worse than I actually am in sound condition.
That certainly puts a few ticks in boxes, Jeff. Would you be happy to work for me?
Yes, it will be nice, sir. Have you got any coaches, sir?
Yes, we've got a few old Great Western coaches coming. They should be here around Monday to Tuesday time.
Good, good, sir. Happy to help. Hope I can still move.
It will be fine, Jeff. We'll soon get you moving along fine. Don't worry. Now then, I have to go, Jeff. I'll leave you in the capable hands of your driver and fireman. I need to go and make some arrangements to see if they can clear that shed out for you at the other end. See you soon. Jeff watched his new boss walk away, now feeling happy and not lonely that he'd got another lease of life.